place between midnight and 1 a.m. Events occur in real time.
Thank you. Austin? ready to go.
One second.
This thing ended up going double or not? Or?
One has died, and the suspect was injured during the melee. So.
Okay.
Anyway, you guys ready?
Mm-hmm.
This is going to be, I'll just look at you.
Yeah, okay.
Or between
fine.
Us, either way you want.
I like your left eye better. Okay. at about 2:45 this morning, Sheriff's Department received a 911 call from a neighbor here at the location that described a female screaming in the street that her husband had been shot. Several of our units arrived shortly thereafter to find the suspect sitting on the front porch here at the residence, saying he'd shot a male who'd come into his house. Turns out that the male victim, who succumbed to his injuries a short time ago, is friends with the suspect, and they were here partying all night long, and they do this on a regular basis. The wife came down to get the victim and actually witnessed the shooting and had to run from the suspect to avoid being shot. After that, the suspect was detained, and the victim was also transported to the University Medical Center, where he succumbed to his injuries.
Any motivation for the shooting at this time? What is the suspect's version? Do you have anything on that right now?
Nothing at this time of any motivation. We're unsure of why it happened. We just do know that they have been acquaintances, and they do frequent each other's homes from time to time here on the street.
And the age of the deceased?
I believe he's approximately in his mid-30s this time.
And the suspect?
I believe about the same. They're both in their mid-30s, I believe.
Could you give complete descriptions of both the suspect and the victim?
Let me go grab that, and you guys can cut some more tape in.
Okay. I'm not.
Thank you.
Donut on my face, do I?
You look good.
You want a donut? We got donuts in the car.
Okay, go ahead and tell me what you have out here today.
Well, this is the fourth year that the Highway Patrol has been involved in the Salvation Army giveaway here in Sacramento, and this is also part of our Trips for Toys program the Highway Patrol is run now, and the community's been very giving this year. We're very pleased with this event. As you can see, a lot of people in need here in Sacramento County. So we're very happy to have officers out here assisting the Salvation Army, giving away toys to these folks this year.
And how many people do you think are going to come out here today?
Salvation Army has estimated 4,500 people this morning. And when I got out here before 7 o'clock, we had at least a mile and a half line of people in cars waiting to get in. And that was till they were here. It started at 4 o'clock to get in line.
I noticed you had the cars strung back and forth. Block after block, so how many vehicles do you think you got?
Well, 4,500 people, we probably had at least 2,000 cars here. I figure at least two people per car. There's a lot of people in need here. Besides toys, we also have food to give away. So people come in here and they get food, and they come in here and get toys. And there are a lot of toys here this year. The community's really been, really opened up their hearts this year and really gave.
This is a pretty good feeling, contact with the public for you, CHP, isn't it?
Well, that's a good feeling for us. And we work with other agencies out here besides the Salvation Army. Toys for Tots and Marines are out here. Marines Reserve are a big part of this. And we're just glad to be part of this. And this really, you know, this is our way to give back to the community. Well, the community are the ones who give us the toys to give to these folks. So it's really nice.
And could you say your name and spell your last name?
Max Hartley, H-A-R-T-L-E-Y.
Thank you very much, Max.
Okay, buddy.
That's not my car, but yeah. I know better. I park out.
Hold on, Corey. Got it back?
At 8:20 this morning, we got a 911 call.
Camera.
You good?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. 8:20 this morning, we got a 911 call for a report of a structure fire at the 6,000 block of Walurga Boulevard in North Highlands. When our firefighters got on scene, we had three victims out in front of the house. And after looking at it further, we found out that a passerby and two of our friends from the sheriff's departments, Deputy Coons and Deputy Peterson, actually helped a citizen rescue these two of the three victims out of the house. And two of the victims are in critical condition right now. They're being transported to UC Davis. A third is being transported to UC Davis for smoke inhalation. So we're really glad that they were here and appreciate their efforts.
Can you go ahead and introduce them now?
Yeah, Deputy Coons and Deputy Peterson, Sacramento Sheriff's Office.
And can you go over real quick what kind of equipment response he has today?
Well, it's a single alarm. We have three engines, actually two ladder trucks, and a few paramedic ambulances. And we're just, again, we're very thankful that our sheriff deputies were in the area and they were able to help us out because it could have been much worse for the victims.
Thank you very much, sir.
Yep.
We just, with the help of the citizen, were able to pull the garage open, and then the guy started coming out by himself, and we pulled him out of the smoke onto the grass.
Really? What kind of fire involvement did the house have at the time when you got here?
I didn't see the flame, just a lot of smoke, a lot of black smoke.
And once you got them out of the log, how long did it take the fire to get here and get things going?
Seconds.
Really?
Yeah. They showed right after we did.
And can you tell me
get the door open and get inside to help the man who's in there.
How do you spell your name first and last name?
First name is Matt, M-A-T-T. Last name is Peterson, P-E-T-E-R-S-E-N.
Thank you, sir. And can you spell your name and first and last name?
First name is Tom, T-O-M. Last name is Koontz, K-O-O-N-T-Z.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Bye-bye.
We did transport one of our firefighters. He does have some burns on his ear and his neck area. It's minor, but we are taking him over to the hospital to get checked out, and hopefully he'll be just fine.
And would you put him as one of the early entry firefighters?
Yeah, he was one of the first ones that made entry into the building. So he there was quite a bit of heat and fire inside the building, and he did burn and get some burns out of it.
And what facility was he transported?
Transported to Mercy San Juan.
Okay, thank you very much.
You bet.
We don't know. Exactly. We put the report in here.
Why?
I don't like flags.
You think I like you to be on television?
I don't need that.
I hear you. Yep.